This is SolidWorks. To start a new part or assembly, click the New tab and this window will pop up. For the purpose of this video, click Part, then OK. At the end of the video, this will be your final part. Back to the blank part file. Go to the Command Manager tab and click on the Sketch tab. Click Sketch on the Sketch tab. These planes will correspond to your drawing. Click on Front Plane. To make sure you are in the correct set of units, click the Unit System button to check you are in MMGS. Back to the Command Manager tab. Still in the Sketch tab, click on the circle. Click on the origin with your cursor and hold it. Drag it out and release it. To create a smaller circle, click on the origin and drag the cursor out. Click on the green check mark to accept your sketch. Select Smart Dimension on the Sketch tab. Click on the inner circle and drag the cursor to place the dimension. In the dimension box, type in 75 millimeters. Dimension the outside circle. Change the dimensions to 150 millimeters. The sketch changes colors from blue to black to show that it is fully defined. Click on the Feature tab on the Command Manager tab. Select Extruded Boss. Change the depth to 10 millimeters and select the green check mark. To change the view orientation, click on the view orientation on the Standard Views toolbar. Change the orientation to back view. Go to the Sketch tab and click on the circle to create another circle from the origin. Click on the Smart Dimension and select the circle. Dimension the circle to 150 millimeters. To change a dimension already set, double-click on the dimension. Change the dimension to 100 millimeters. Notice how the sketch is still blue, it's not fully defined. Zoom in with your scroll button on your mouse. Click on Display Delete Relations and click on Add Relations. Select the circle. Select the origin. Click on Concentric under Add Relations and click on the green check mark. Click on the Feature tab. Click on the Extruded Boss. Change the depth to 60 millimeters. Change the view orientation to back view. Click on the Sketch tab. Click on the circle. Create a circle from the origin. Use the Smart Dimension property. Dimension the circle to 75 millimeters. Click on the Features tab. Click on Extruded Cut. For extrusion type, select Through All. Change back to Front View using the Standard View toolbar. Click on the Sketch tab. Click on the circle. A message window will pop up if you have not selected a plane or face to draw your sketch. Select the face of the part. Now you can draw a circle from the origin and select for construction only. It will only help you sketch and not show in the final drawing. Click on the line property and scroll down to center line. Go to the origin, but do not click on it. click on the edge of the circle. Click on the other edge of the circle. Click on the Smart Dimension and select the circle. Change the dimensions to 100 millimeters and select the green check mark. Notice how the horizontal line changes its length automatically. A relationship has been created. If you want to change the dimensions again, double-click on the dimensions in the drawing. Change dimensions to 125 millimeters. Click on the circle. Create a circle from where the line intersects the circle. Repeat the process at the other end. Click on the Smart Dimension. Dimension the circle on the right. Dimension the circle to 25 millimeters. To change the dimension, double-click the dimension and change it to 15 millimeters. To add a relationship, click on Display Delete Relations and select Add Relation. Click on the right circle, then on the left circle. Add an equal relationship. Now both circles are equal. Click on the Features tab. Click on the Extruded Cut. The yellow highlighted area shows the depth of cut. Let's change the depth of cut. Change the depth of cut to Up to Next. Now the depth of cut is within the boundaries of the material. Rotate the part to see that you have created two holes in the place of the circles. Still in the Features tab, click on Fill It. To select the inner edge of the part, rotate the part, then select the outer edge. To delete an edge, select it from the list on the left under Items to Fill It and click the Delete button on the keyboard. Select the partial view. Change the radius to 3 millimeters. Notice how the part changes. Make sure to select Constant Radius. After accepting a feature, you can always go back to edit the part. Click on the face of the part and right-click on the mouse. Select the Edit Feature button. Change the radius to 4.5 millimeters. To fillet other entities, one must select the entity. Select the outer edge. Click on Fillet in the Features tab. Change the radius to 2 millimeters. This feature only fillets the edge selected. Zoom in by using the scrolling down on the scroll button on the mouse. Select the second outer edge and the outer edge of the smaller circle in the back of the part. The settings of the previous action will be saved. Keep previous settings. Now the outer edges have been filleted with the same radius. Another way to delete undesired filleted entities is selecting the entity and use the Edit feature. Deselect the edge by clicking on it. Now there are only two filleted edges. Rotate the part and select the smaller circles. Click on the Fillet from the Features tab. Change the radius to 1 millimeter and select the circle to the left as well. The part is finished and the final part can be seen by rotating the part. The view of the part can be changed by clicking on the display style and selecting shaded. To save the part, go to the toolbar at the top and click on the blue disk. Look for the file or place where you want to save your work. You can change the name of the file or leave it as Part 1. Save the part as a part file and click Save. Now this part is ready for shop drawings.